matchup tonight, we'll see the Phoenix Mercury going up against the Las Vegas Aces. Along with Tim Swartz and Brian Benefitemi, I'm Blake Suniga, and we're happy to have you along for another great game. And so off the tip, it's Phoenix. Rossi with it. It's Kia Nurse on the wing. The three ball. Rebound by the Aces. It's Erica Hamby with the drive. Second chance shot. Hamby. Nice fake, but the layup off the mark. Pass to Diggin Smith. Now here's Little. And Hamby gets the whistle that time. That is her first foul of the game.
Yeah, that's a quick foul to pick up here in the opening quarter.
Aces on D. And stolen by Asia Wilson.
That was a little bit of a gift there. Nice steal, but probably a pass that shouldn't have been made in the first place.
Nice little way to get on the board.
And just like that, the first lead is theirs.
Now here's Diggin Smith. Passed a Little. Nice defense from Asia Wilson.
I like the D. They weren't about to swing the door open and let her cruise in for the layup. Good job.
I'd say you're fooling yourself if you think Wilson's afraid of a little contact, because she'll go up against anybody.
Now here's Diggin Smith. Here's Nurse, and Asia Wilson with the block. Here's Williams, and Skylar Diggin-Smith with the swat.
Look, blocking shots is all about staying disciplined, and I like to see Diggin-Smith put her instincts and timing to good use there.
Here's Williams. Good, and so Asia Wilson with the assist. Now about 2 minutes gone by in the first quarter. And they could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Yeah, too many empty possessions. I mean, it's simple. They need points. Total focus from Diggin Smith. The bump doesn't stop her from hitting the shot.
Now here's Gray. Hamby outside. Pass to Cambage. Over Griner. The putback controls the rebound and puts it back up and in.
Simply tenacious on the O-boards, Wilson attacks the loose ball with the intent of putting it back in the hoop.
Rossi with it. Williams there. Here's Diggin Smith. Hamby grabs the miss.
The shots aren't dropping yet. They've missed four of their first five shots.
The offensive rebound. Here's Wilson. And that one goes in as she's fouled. It'll be 3 points if she can convert the free throw.
One shot.
Number one picks in the draft face a lot of pressure, but Wilson is laser focused and has remained composed.
And the Mercury call time here.
Yeah, I think the coach is watching a lot of shots they normally make rimming out, and it has to be frustrating. Maybe see if they could create some scoring opportunities at the free throw line.
That may be the answer for them, but you know, ultimately, I expect them to shoot their way out of this slump.
it's the Mercury with the ball.
Yeah, it's a 10-point game.
Diana Taurasi on the wing.
Megan Smith's shot is off.
Such tough defense there against one of the better finishers in the game.
Here's Wilson. She can't get that one. Now Phoenix takes it the other way. Now here's Diggins Smith. Gray defending. Passed a little. And a foul on the shot. She'll go to the stripe for two.
What a play in attack mode and get inside.
And the defense gets their money's worth on that foul. Stopping the layup and not giving up the and one.
She's getting her first free throw attempts of the night. Good on the free throw. She hits the second from the line. The Aces with the lead. Now Gray. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game for her. Count it.
The ball movement on this run has been fantastic, and it's a big part of why they've been able to get good looks.
Absolutely. The defense unable to react quickly enough to deal with their passing.
Now here's Taurasi, and she uses the glass on the layup.
When you make more buckets than anybody in WNBA history, you have to score in the paint. Taurasi never scared inside.
Gambane. Here's Wilson. Goes up again. Doesn't go for her. Excellent D there from Brittany Griner. Diana Taurasi on the wing. And it's off from three-point range.
Hard to figure out why she didn't bury that one. Have a defender near her.
Pass to Williams. Shoots over Taurasi. Williams can't get it to go. The Mercury trail. Here's Diggins Smith. Lays it up and banks it in.
One of the most coachable players in the league, Diggins Smith's curiosity leads to her constant improvement.
Now here's Williams. 5 points in the game. Here's Gray. And she is on the money with her first shot today.
I like their hustle here early. They've struck first on the offensive glass.
Those second chance buckets really contributing to the lead.
Now a timeout called by Phoenix. One of the stories here, Asia Wilson getting it done today.
Yeah, I think I know what they're going to be talking about this timeout. She's been taking it to them all game inside, and they haven't been able to stop her. They need to put up a better fight.
Here is Diggins Smith inside, and she finishes nicely on the layup.
Credit Diggins Smith for finding the open teammate. Skyler has insane hoops IQ, knows where all the chess pieces are.
Here's Paris, outside Plum, pass to Young, right side Carson, six on the shot clock. And it's good with time running down on the shot clock.
Off to a strong start on the glass. 6 points off second chance buckets.
Yeah, you like their effort level here in the early going. And if you don't, oh well, because I like it. You know, they're just making things happen.
Now here's Hartley. Turner. She's guarded by Wilson. And it's Turner missing.
What a start they've gotten off to on the boards. They've come out banging.
And you know, I've seen it a million times. When a game starts off like this, there's an intimidation factor that comes into play.
Good work there as it goes.
Nice drive by Walker. Remember, she was the top recruit in the nation out of high school, has incredible offensive potential.
Pass to Plum. Young.
Wilson in the post. 9 points in the game.
Give it up for her inside. Great rebound, and she had to fight for it.
Here's Griner, guarded by Young. Outside for Deegan Smith. That's good, and so Brittany Griner gets the assist.
I like the way she's taking advantage of what the defense is giving her, and she's been a key contributor for them this quarter.
And the Aces call time here.
Looks like the coach saw some things out there that need adjusting. It's going to take a little time to talk it over.
Yeah, and never a bad idea to use a timeout if there's something that's got you concerned.
Carson, pass to Young, and the layup's good off the glass.
You sit back and enjoy the poise from Young. Maybe not the highest percentage shot with the contact, but she still sinks it.
Hartley, left side, and she was fouled on the way up. Two free throws for her. And first trip to the free throw line for her in this one. The first one falls.
What a story of perseverance. Neo Rancock Okunwe went to college in Canada at a Division II school, but has worked her way to the Canadian national team and the WNBA.
On that one, so she goes 1 for 2 at the line. The Aces leading. Here's Carson. Terrific assist and a nice finish. Just a solid play all around.
If someone is open, Plum will find them. She's got phenomenal court vision.
Now here's Walker. Pass to Hartley. No good there. Great D that time from Jackie Young. Three-pointer, Kelsey Plum. And it's Phoenix with the rebound. Outside, Deegan Smith. Kelsey Plum with a steal. And it's in.
Backed by her solid footwork, Turner knows a thing or two about scoring inside.
Outside, Plum. Harris. Turner grabs the board. Floats one, right with the steal. Outside, Young. And a foul called on the shot. Got her on the way up that time, so she'll shoot two. That one on Deegan Smith.
The foul drawn by Young, it's hard to keep her in front of you, and that opens up so much more of her game.
And she's got her first free throws of the night right here.
Take a break. Two shots.
The first free throw is good.
The top overall pick of the draft by Las Vegas in 2019, Jackie Young came out of college early, becoming the third junior to ever be taken with the top pick after Candace Parker and Jewel Lloyd.
And good on both. The Mercury Trail.
Hartley, left side. Ring Kakagunwe, good.
No one around her. Rhea Hartley found the open teammate. Easy hoop.
Here's Las Vegas. Pass to Plum. Yes. And it's Tanisha Wright picking up the assist.
Give an assist there, not for a pass, but for the solid screen set on the inside that freed her up and really just made that layup possible.
And here's Walker. He's on the right. Foul call that time on the way up, and that'll give her two chances at the free throw line.
Can't be too aggressive guarding Walker. She's good at taking it and getting to the strike.
It's her first trip to the line. And she knocks down the first one.
And coming into the WNBA, Megan Walker was already a standout talent, a top 10 pick who was Conference Player of the Year during her junior and final season.
And that one goes in, two from the line that time. And they're scoring pretty well as we conclude the first quarter. The Aces on top, they're up by five. Let's take a quick break, and then it's on to the second quarter after this. And guys, what's your take on the Aces so far?
I love the hustle they're showing here in the first.
It's showing up on the scoreboard, too. A lot of second chance points. And as you said, it's due to their hustle.
Now here's Cambage. Wyatt so far offensively searching for her first points of the game. Outside Plum. Phoenix on D, trailing by five. To the middle. Pass to Plum, just four to shoot. Shoots over Hartley, and it's Phoenix with the rebound.
That's a shot she's got to hit. You don't get too many better looks than that range.
Right outside. Bambi outside. And we played through the first minute here in the second. That does not fall. Still looking for her first basket after three shots.
What a passer. Diana Taurasi sees the game like few ever have. Finds teammates in great positions.
Pass to Hamby. Here's Cambage. Here's Plum. Misses the layup.
She just continues to struggle from the field. Now, her team has been able to overcome her performance, but I'm not certain that she's going to be able to turn it around today.
Now here's Hartley, looking for her first basket still in this one. Back to Taurasi. That doesn't go on the chance to tie. Up top Plum, she's guarded by Hartley. Here's Paris. That drops, and it comes off an assist from Kelsey Plum.
Just the way they wanted, within touching distance of the rim.
It's Kia Nurse on the wing. Turner. It drops for her third basket. She's only missed one shot.
Flexing her physical attributes to complete the basket through contact. That's a heads-up play from Turner.
Pass to Cambage. Bucket is good.
Oh, she's got such a great touch and feel around the rim. She made that reverse look easy, but trust me when I tell you, it's not.
Now a timeout called by Phoenix.
Hey, it's hard to see. She's shaking up. No choice but to take a timeout. Let her get some medical attention. Hope she's okay.
change it up. And we're now a little over 2.5 minutes into this second quarter. Williams with it, now guarded by Little.
Do not test Reiner, the active leader in rejections. Why? 6'9" plus timing.
Here's Wilson, 9 points in the game.
Great, that's good. The defenders didn't really even get a sniff of her on that move to the iron.
Hartley outside, Rossi outside. Laid in with a nice touch off the glass.
Well, it's that natural feel for the game that allows Taurasi to see plays before they materialize. I mean, she's creating while other people are still getting up to speed.
This is her first opportunity at the line this evening.
Liz Cambage at the line for two.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And the first one drops.
It was 5 years between WNBA seasons for Liz Cambage. And what'd she do when she returned to the league? Lead the league in baskets made, a talented offensive force.
And good on the second, so she makes both. And just under 3.5 minutes played here in the second quarter. Pass to Nurse. Little. Here's DeRossi. Nice defense from Asia Wilson.
Well, controlling the boards, they're +5 in that category.
Yeah, and look, rebounding, it's not a glamour stat, but you look at the scoreboard and you see the result.
And she continues to search for her rhythm. It's eluded her so far.
Out to the right wing. And the call is going to be, yep, an illegal screen.
The lead they have is a result of how they've taken care of the ball. That's only their first turnover.
And it's the Mercury with the ball. 7-point differential. Here's DeRossi. Makes it off the glass.
It's okay. You play good defense. Sometimes you get beat. You aren't the first person Diana Taurasi's done that to.
Bambi outside. Pass to Gray. Back to Hamby. Just 5 to shoot. To the paint. Here's Nurse. Yes, and a nice assist from Diana Taurasi.
Taking initiative in the open floor. When Nurse works hard in these situations, time out, good things happen.
And the Aces call time here. Outside. Raquana Williams for three. Mercury with the rebound. And they're right on the brink of taking the lead.
This is an absolutely critical moment in this game.
First outside. Pass to Walker. 5 on the clock. Shoots over Williams. Ooh, no luck on that one.
So Las Vegas will take it the other way. They've led by as many as 11 points.
Yeah, Young is such an effective ball handler, spots the wide open shooter and passes the rock.
Nurse outside. Griner shoots over Cambage. A nice shot by Griner.
That assist got a little nod from her teammate after the bucket.
The Aces with the lead. Pass to Cambage. Williams takes the three. Griner with the rebound. And the Mercury with possession. Nurse outside. Now Griner, defended by Cambage.
Arguably the best ever inside. Griner is incredibly hard to stop without fouling.
And this is her first free throw of the game.
She wasn't playing professional basketball. Griner said she's always wanted to follow her father's footsteps and be a police officer.
And that one falls, so she hits both of them. Here's Young. Gray outside. Shoots the three. That's in, and she's now 3 for 3 and looking sharp.
Always seems to be in the right position. Gray's patience and experience make her the bright player she is.
Back to Diggins-Smith. Here's Griner, and she battles for the ball and gets the second chance bucket.
These defenders look overmatched right now, especially inside.
They've given up 10 of the last 12 points from close range, so I'd have to agree.
Now here's Young. Her second shot goes in. Off to a good start. 2 for 2.
With lightning quickness and a great handle, Young can drive at will. And you really can't double her because she's so good at passing the ball.
Here's Walker. Back to Diggins-Smith. 4 on the shot clock. Goes as the official calls the foul. Count it, and she'll shoot one more at the line.
Exploding onto the scene during her senior year of college, Skylar Diggins-Smith has delivered at the pro level, piling up all-star appearances since entering the WNBA in 2013.
Pass to right. Wilson. Here's Carson. The second chance effort and a missed layup.
Just stay closer. I mean, really, that's all the defender had to do there.
A nice shot by Diggins-Smith.
Well, you gotta like her shot selection today. She set the bar for the rest of the team.
Now here's Young. 6 points for her. Here's Paris. Tries again. And that one's good. Wilson.
That hoop took tremendous mental toughness from Wilson. Not gonna let the bump disrupt her.
Left side, Diggins-Smith. And there it is. And here are the Aces now. They trail by one. Right outside. Young. Pass to Wilson. Shoots over Diggins-Smith. Fades away and sinks the tough shot.
Coaches love a solid shooter like Wilson, a player you can rely on to get production from.
Here's Walker. She's tightly guarded. The fader. They shoot again. And two shots coming up at the line as she gets fouled on the shot. And the foul called on the Las Vegas Aces. She shot two free throws in the game, made one, missed one. No good on that one. That one misses. Now 5 seconds separating the shot clock and the game clock. Outside Plum. Got a piece of it. Hartley outside. Rain Kakakunwe. Taurasi with it. 1 second left. And we're through the first half of play here in what's been a good one. The Aces on top. They're up by one. And time now for the halftime break with the third quarter soon to follow on 2K Sports. We're seeing a tremendous game from Skylar Diggins-Smith.
She has that slasher mentality, and we really saw evidence of it in the first half. She got to the rim again and again and kept on scoring.
Look, we know that she's got that great first step, but she must have woken up on the right side of the bed today because she looks fast out there.
The third quarter now beginning. Both sides looking to pull away in the last half of the game. Pass to Cambage. Williams. Here's Wilson. And the shot goes in.
Well, you might be surprised by Williams' court vision, but she isn't. She knows she can make sharp passes offensively.
Now here's Taurasi. Outside, Diggins-Smith. Now here's Griner to the inside. Guns up empty down low.
Those chances, usually they're 2 points for her. The D, I guess, did just enough to bother her.
Pass to Nurse. She can't hit that time. Asia Wilson with some nice D. Gray outside. And here's Cambage, defended by Nurse. Cambage with the bucket.
Four of their last five makes came off a high-quality shot inside.
And that's right out of the textbook. They're having their way down low right now.
Down low. Reiner. A good finish at the rack off the slick feed.
One of the advantages for Nurse, she's 6 feet, so tall for a point, allows her to get a clear view of the whole court.
Now here is Hamby. No scoring yet from her, but that's likely to change. Taurasi, and she drops in the layup off glass.
She's a very strong finisher on the fast break.
And always in control, even at full speed like that.
So impressive.
Pass to Cambage. Now here's Williams. She's covered by Taurasi. Releases from 15. Four on the clock. Taurasi Gray for three. And it's Phoenix with the rebound. Here's Diggins-Smith. Add another one in the scoring column for her. She's 7 for 10 from the field.
An excellent display of passing out there, fellas.
Time out.
8 of the last 10 points have been assisted on.
Some great passing. They keep on finding the open teammate. Good ball movement.
Timeout called the Aces.
Yeah, I think the coach is trying to take the wind out of their sails here. They're on the wrong end of a run, and need to sort things out offensively and defensively.
Yeah, things were starting to spiral out of control on them a little bit, and a timeout was a no-brainer there.
Yeah, exactly, Brian.
A little over 2.5 minutes off the clock in this final half of play.
Is it just me, or does it feel like she's gotten every rebound in this game?
No, it's not just you. And look, a 20-plus rebounding game just isn't something we get to see very often.
We just sit back and enjoy the show.
Absolutely. And now we see them really working it inside.
Yeah, getting quality looks around the rim. That's fueling this run.
That one, good for two.
Because of her ability to hit mid-range shots, Cambage adds a different dimension to her team's spacing.
Now a timeout called by Phoenix.
Well, they want to tinker with the game plan a little bit, and now's the time to do it.
Yeah, there was clearly some things going on out there that the coaching staff just wasn't a fan of.
Here's Nurse. 6 points for her. Megan Smith. Reiner's shot is off. A little under 2.5 minutes off the clock now in the third quarter. Hamby covered by Little. Pass to Gray. Hamby. Good. And it's Chelsea Gray who picks up the assist.
Well, nothing was going down for her in the first half, but since the break, she has been on target.
Outside, Diggin Smith. Super great. The Mercury with another miss.
You don't see that too often. Plenty of space, and she whiffs on an open jumper.
Phoenix trailing here. Now to Rossi. 8 points for her. Pass to Griner. Just 5 on the clock. Back to Diggin Smith. That counts. She's put up 13 shots and now has made 8 of them.
Well, precise decision making has to be one of Diggin Smith's standout talents. I mean, she really has a deep knowledge of the game.
Here's Gray. They get it back. Here's Cambay. Brittany Griner with a defensive effort. Pass to Taurasi. And here is Little. Banked in off the glass.
Timeout.
Excellent work offensively to get that shot attempt into a can't-miss area.
Now a timeout called by Las Vegas. It's been quite the game for Diggin Smith.
She's torching them right now, and they're going to talk it over and try to figure out how to slow her roll.
making some changes here.
The Aces trailing. Outside Plum. Wilson outside. From deep three-point range. Out of bounds, it'll go to the Mercury. And it's the Mercury with the ball. Rossi outside. Pass to Turner. The shot will not fall. And Las Vegas the other way now. Here's Young. Outside Plum. Harris. And Ring Kakakunwe pulls it down. Up top, Hartley. Started by Young. And Carson is going to pick up the foul. That's foul number two for her. Here's Ring Kakakunwe. To Rossi. Guarded by Young. Pass to Walker. Five to shoot. It's over right. Off the left rim and out.
That's a shot she had to take.
No question. The decision was good. Just didn't execute.
Phoenix leading. Here's Ring Kakakunwe. Walker with it. She's guarded by Wright. Pass to Hartley.
Tipped away.
Now here's Walker. Here's the three. A rebound by Paris. Right, right side. Rhea Hartley with some nice D. Now here's Walker. Carson covering. Right wing. Walker up top. And again, Phoenix no good.
You know, you watch her and you see her mechanics are totally out of whack right now. She's lost all feel for her shot.
Yeah, and it's not hard to tell. You know, just look at her numbers right now. Nothing is going down for her.
Now here's Hartley. She hasn't yet put up any points in this one. Turner, she's guarded by Wright. They get it back. And a good offensive board, and she gets the bucket.
A great offensive rebounder because of her awareness and effort. I'm impressed with Turner.
Left side, Young. Pass to Paris. Plum. That shot off.
It's almost like she's trying to make things hard on herself. Work it around. Get an easier shot.
Ring Kakakunwe. So she gets the whistle. Contact on the way up. Two shots next. Jackie Young picks one up. And she hasn't capitalized on her chances at the line, only making one free throw.
Shooting two.
And the first one at the line is good. So both teams changing it up here. And she makes both free throws. And here is Young. 8 points for her. And they've been struggling here offensively.
Bit of a dry spell for sure.
Pass to Cambage. Plum. Looking to get it going. It doesn't go for her. Now Phoenix takes it the other way. To the middle. Shots good by Taurasi.
What an excellent assist. It really led her to the perfect spot.
Outside Young. Pass to Cambage.
Unloads from 13 feet. Offensive rebound. And good that time.
We've seen an obvious improvement out of her since halftime. And she just didn't really have a whole lot working for her in the first half.
The Mercury with possession. The lead is two. Inside, Reiner. Yes, and it's Skylar Diggins-Smith with the assist that time.
Yeah, seeing over defenders contributes to Griner's dominance down low. She's just lethal around the rim.
7 second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. From 13, it's rebounded by Phoenix. Liz Cambage with a steal. By Hamby.
There's a reason Hamby shoots such a high percentage. She's intelligent in knowing how to score inside.
Three quarters of play and a close game here. Mercury out in front. They lead by two. We're going to step aside for just a second, but join us right back here for the start of quarter number four next. And it's time now to bring you our State Farm assist of the game.
I'm so happy we get to see this pass just one more time. A magnificent feed. You love to see the two kind of taking over the playmaking duties with this much skill.
Yeah, that is some dime dropping, guys. Accurate and on time.
This is for the kids. Come on, man. And thanks for joining us again as the fourth quarter of play is set to get rolling. It's been a close battle to this point. Now here's Nurse. The teardrop falls in.
What fantastic touch from Nurse. It's a huge ace up her sleeve. The ability to put it in the hoop from inside.
Pass to Cambage. Wilson. Turner grabs the board. Outside, Diggins-Smith. Skylar Diggins-Smith drawing the double team. And we're going to have a jump ball. It's tied up there. And here are the Aces now. The Aces trailing. Outside, Williams. To the inside. Here's Cambage. And the shot is good.
Love the toughness from Cambage. You didn't think a little contact would throw her off, did you?
Outside, Diggins-Smith. Passed a little. And here is Nurse. Shot clock at five. Sweet little floater.
You see why Nurse operates way more than your average guard inside. It's not just her height. It's also the mentality.
Now here's Gray. Now here's Diggins-Smith. Beyond the arc. Hamby grabs the miss. Last quarter play, about 2 minutes in now. Pass to Cambage. Erica Hamby on the wing. Shoots over Little. Cambage, shot's good.
She's having a great half here, exactly the reverse of the first half.
To the paint. The bucket is good, and she'll have a chance for one more. Liz Cambage picks one up. And the Mercury making a change here. in the fourth quarter here, just under 2.5 minutes gone. Outside Williams. Pass to Cambage. Back to Williams. Shot clock at 6. Over Nurse. And Little pulls it down. Phoenix leading. Taurasi outside. And it's blocked by Asia Wilson.
The great length of Wilson, it really aids her rejecting shots. Asia's normally top 5 in the league in shot clocks.
Williams can't get it to go. And here are the Mercury. Here in the fourth, they've only allowed just 4 points. A look at the clock, a little under 3.5 minutes gone in the fourth. That one falls.
The awareness of Gray, a terrific teammate who is good at recognizing when someone on a team is uncovered.
Here's Diggin Smith. Count the basket.
The defense on her has to be airtight, guys, and that was far from it.
And Wilson gets it to go.
She is setting this place on fire. Her shooting has been off the charts.
Here's Taurasi. A rebound by Asia Wilson.
Didn't see that miss coming. She's usually so good from that range.
They grab their own miss.
She's not exactly killing them from deep. I mean, she had one free ball in the first half, yes, but still none here in the second.
Here's Gray. She's off on that one. Now Phoenix takes it the other way. Outside, Diggin Smith. Taurasi, defended by Cambage. And the layup is good.
One of the most daring scorers in the league, Taurasi excels at finding ways to score despite tight defense.
Now here is Hamby. Outside Williams. Kicks it out to Wilson. Shoots over Little. A nice shot by Wilson.
They've had assists now on their last 3 baskets.
Everybody always thinks it's passing that gets you assists, but also their movement off the ball, it's created those opportunities.
And Little gets it to go.
They're finding lanes to the hoop every time down. 5 buckets in a row from the paint.
And on the flip side, the defenders have to show more fight on the interior.
Or at least some fight.
Now here's Cambage. And Diggin Smith pulls it down. Here's the break. Number 3, Diana Taurasi. Not gonna go that time. The Aces go the other way with it.
Yeah, I mean, she has been way off the mark this quarter. It is getting rough.
And so she draws the foul on the shot. A trip to the line to shoot 2.
You know, we've seen Hamby take it more at defenders over the course of her career. Earning more trips to the line, a great sign.
Two shots.
And she makes the first.
It seems like every year, De'Erica Hamby just gets better. And that's a testament to her drive and work ethic.
She's perfect from the line this time. And the Mercury with possession. It's a 3-point game. Pass to Nurse. Here's Diggin Smith. For 3. It's rebounded by Liz Cambage.
Oh, man. That's one she'd like to have over.
Unloads from 13 feet. Great positioning on the putback.
This game has been very close in a lot of areas, but rebounding is one thing that's gone in their favor.
Yeah, effort and determination on the glass, they really can compensate for a lot of deficiencies.
Now here's Little. Taurasi outside. Misses the 3.
Well, with a clear look at the basket, she doesn't really miss a lot of those.
Pass to Williams. Nurse with the double team. Hamby with the ball. Outside Plum to take the lead. And too long on the shot.
Well, it's not a bad look for her on that shot, but it just doesn't seem to be her night. And look, everyone has one. They're not rotating quickly enough on defense down low.
They've got to provide more resistance inside.
Now a timeout called by Las Vegas.
They could tell their players were dragging a bit and called timeout to let them catch their breath.
Double team on Asia Wilson. Cam Beige. Outside Plum. Looking to get back on track. Offensive rebound. And it's blocked by Brittany Griner. And the shot goes in. Phoenix in the lead. Here's Diggin Smith.
Another good rebound. And we know she's giving up some inches to a few of the other players, but that just hasn't mattered.
Now here's Plum. Back to Hamby. And that one drops.
The moment not scaring Hamby, a leader. She takes pleasure in hitting the big shot.
And so she earns a trip to the line. Official saw the contact, and she'll shoot two. Free throw is good, and that ties the game up.
It took Kia Nurse just two seasons to become a WNBA All-Star. She's bursting with talent and only getting better.
And so she's good on both free throws, and that gives them the lead.
She's the player you want at the charity stripe in that situation. I got no doubt about that.
To the inside. They double his Cambage. Hamby misses. And up the court come the Mercury on the break. Nurse with the bucket.
What a shot by Kia Nurse, keeping her team in this. They're lucky to have such a reliable shooter.
Now here's Plum. And stolen by Brittany Griner. Here's Diggin Smith. That's good. And so Brittany Griner gets the assist.
Showing every bit of determination. Diggin Smith's mental toughness keeps her prepared for big moments.
Cambage with the bucket.
Confident and composed when all the chips are on the table. Cambage is able to step up and make a play.
Now here's Taurasi. It's good.
And this is where all of Taurasi's experience comes into play. She's comfortable having the ball in her hands during big-time possessions.
Just a sense of the moment from Cambage. So aware of where we are in the game, the time and score. Liz knows when to put it in the hoop.
Yes!
That just adds to what's probably already an insurmountable lead. I think they'll be leaving here with a win.
Yeah, hard to imagine any other outcome than the one that's staring us right in the face.
Timeout called the Aces. Your thoughts, guys?
Time is the big factor here. You need to get the points fast and then foul.
Yeah, Tim, and it has to be a quick foul. Every second is critical at this stage.
Yeah, they cannot waste any time if they want to come back.
Down low, Wilson.
The basket drops and she gets fouled on the shot.
One free throw coming up for her. They go to the intentional foul.
Yeah, you can't let them hold the ball and just milk those seconds away.
Nope, and you've got to foul. It's going to come down to free throws.
Pressure situation.
Shoot two.
He hits the first one, and that makes it a three-point lead.
She hits both free throws,
and it's a four-point ball game.
Two-possession game now. Some very important free throws there.
Chelsea Plum from outside, and it's Phoenix with the rebound. And they foul intentionally. That's what they have to do at this point.
You have to foul, but I'm sure they would have liked to foul someone different.
No other option, though. They did a good job getting it in her hands and making sure she was the one who'd go to the line.
So the first one drops, and that puts them up five. So she goes two for two at the line, and it's a six-point ball game.
Now that's how you close a game out. Those free throws will bury them for sure.
And so it's Phoenix with the W.